Hello, everyone. My name is Ada Hurst. I'm a lecturer in management engineering, where I've been teaching and researching engineering design for over 10 years. I am so excited to tell you about management engineering. And if after this presentation you have any questions, please do not hesitate to contact me using the address that you see on the slide. So in this presentation, I'll provide a big picture view of the program and its curriculum, and I'll discuss the main career paths and co-op roles that management engineering students take. I'll briefly describe how the program compares to some other programs like business programs, and then tell you about the amazing student experience. Let's start with an overview of the program. Management engineers improve business efficiency in a modern world, which is increasingly more and more digital and data-centric. They apply engineering tools and skills to analyze how organizations operate and make decisions, and then use data to design solutions that can improve systems, products, and processes. The products, systems, and processes that management engineers are working on are very socio-technical. And so what that means is that they are composed of both social and technical aspects of people and technology. And because of that, students in the management engineering program learn how to integrate and apply knowledge from three different areas. The first one is data analytics and operations research. The second is software information systems. And the third is organization science. And so in the next few slides, I'm going to tell you a little bit more about how they integrate these three areas and how this is reflected in the courses. So let's take a big picture view. The program is composed of 14 terms of 4 months each. This is the Waterloo Engineering Way. And so that's 8 academic terms and 6 co-op terms. So the program is almost 5 years in duration, but that includes 2 years of relevant paid work experience. Okay, so let's talk about courses. Students begin their first year with a foundational base with courses in math, science, and engineering fundamentals. And so this also even includes a course in foundations of engineering, of management engineering, and also courses in engineering communication. Beginning in first year, students also begin building their knowledge in the three areas of management engineering. So in the data analytics and operations research area, courses will cover many topics, including advanced probability and statistics, optimization, supply chain management, and simulation. In the software and information systems area, students begin with a basic computer programming course, and then they slowly build their skills term after term. They learn about software design, software management, and the design of computer interfaces. What I want to emphasize here is that we have no requirements for any prior programming experience for our students. We do not expect to know how to program. And really, the programming and the software is only part of a broader program, the management engineering program. A majority of our alumni do not end up writing code for a living, but they do take advantage of this knowledge of programming because it's so fundamental to the modern and digital world of business. Finally, in the third area, students learn about the important interface between technology and the people and social systems that use it. They learn about economics, people's psychology in organizations, and technology management. In the more senior terms, students begin to integrate all of the knowledge from the three areas and then apply this knowledge to the designing of engineering solutions. Through electives, students can learn about a variety of topics, including machine learning, quality management, scheduling, analytics, and user experience in software products. Core to the program are courses in design methods, and even a sequence of 2 courses in which students work on a big design project. Students learn how to find and analyze a real problem, and then develop a solution to address it. That's what design is. And students can also use these electives to work towards an option. In management engineering, popular options are the one in artificial intelligence and the one in computing. Okay, So what kind of jobs can you get with a management engineering degree? That is a very common question we get. We are very proud of the success that our students and graduates have in securing co-op and full-time jobs in Canada and around the globe. The companies you see on the slide are just some of the ones that regularly employ management engineering students. Our students and graduates are employed in a very wide variety of industries, from software and high tech to banking, finance, supply chain management, communications, manufacturing, healthcare, education, and many, many more. Through our co-op records and also by tracking our graduates over the years, we have over 600 graduates by now. We know that they take on key roles in their organizations. They achieve career paths that are very well paid and have excellent growth opportunities. In the next few slides, I'll highlight four different roles that our students and graduates typically take in industry. Okay, so the first one is product management. It's PM for short. It's a very common career path. And what it does is it takes advantage of management engineers' unique combination of strong technical and soft skills. According to Glassdoor in recent years, product management has been one of the top five jobs in the United States. And what we mean by that, a top job, is we mean when you consider salary, job satisfaction, and available openings. So fundamentally, PM, product management, what they do is they lead cross-functional teams to develop and execute solutions, new solutions or products. At a high level, as shown in the slide, product management requires an understanding of user experience, business, and technology. So product managers will collaborate with various roles in the organization, including user design and user experience teams, data scientists and data engineers, other engineers, marketing, sales. The product manager works with all these different roles in order to define what the product will do, what features it will have, and then plan a strategy for how it will be designed and how it will be developed. The PM will work well with all these different sub teams. It will prioritize the various tasks and features, and then they'll be basically the main go-to person to coordinate all the work, and they ensure to communicate progress and make adjustments to the plan as necessary. Our students work as product managers in many, many companies, and especially in the software, high tech, and finance industries. The second very common career path for our students are basically filling roles in business or data analytics, and also increasingly data science. This is a very in-demand role. As of 2022, according to Glassdoor, data science is the third best job in the United States. These roles overall rely heavily on the use of data. What students and graduates do is they transform big, potentially very messy data into information that can be used to make critical business decisions. Business or data analysts answer important questions by analyzing the data, extracting insights, identifying trends, and then prescribing solutions. Data scientists specifically focus on building the needed data sets, and then they develop the algorithm and models that can be used to make predictions about the future. For management engineering graduates, business and data analytics and data science roles are pervasive in many industries, and they take on very different but still similar titles, such as product data analysts, business intelligence analysts, data scientists, data engineers, technical system analysts. The list goes on and on. Many management engineering students work as consultants for some of the major consulting firms. Consulting is a very broad umbrella and includes various industries and really companies of all sizes. And consulting can be a great career choice, especially if you like ambiguity, if you want to work with different industries, you want to try different projects and work with different managers. At a high level, consulting companies offer their services to client companies on a project-by-project basis. And so a consultant, when they're assigned to a project, they will work with a client company to define the problem, investigate the sources of the problem, identify best practices that are relevant to the situation, and then they'll design a solution and implementation plan. Now, depending on the kind of consulting they're doing, they may or may not be directly involved in the implementation phase. There are many types of consulting. The main ones are technology consulting, which is technology strategy, technology implementation, people, human consulting, and management consulting, which is more business focused. And we find our students find careers in all these three areas, but especially in technology consulting. Finally, the last big types of positions that our students take are those in software engineering and software development. And this is a wide umbrella and covers the development of code in apps and websites and even in electronics. This type of job is found in many different fields and everywhere from startups to finance, small businesses to big tech companies like Apple or Facebook. So given the very high industry demand for software developers and software engineers, many management engineering students will take advantage of the strong training that they get in software information systems through courses, electives, and even through their co-op. And then they choose careers in software development and engineering. Many students come to the program with little or no programming experience, but many find an interest in this area, and they build strong programming skills throughout the program. In software development, much of the daily work is actually problem solving, finding the best way to implement a new feature, and then you write the code and you test it as you best can. And this might include both back-end and front-end applications. What's really interesting is the work is both creative and technical, and software developers are continuously learning. So how does management engineering compare to other programs? Many students are interested in management engineering because they're looking for a engineering plus business type of program. And it's true, given the emphasis on understanding the people and organizations that will use design systems and processes, management engineering actually has four core courses in economics and the study of organizations. And this is the largest portion out of all of other engineering programs. So really the program is the most businessy out of all other engineering programs. And as mentioned before, we do have many management engineering grads that pursue what I would say business-oriented careers, such as business strategy consultants, business process improvement leads, and so on. But what I want to emphasize is that management engineering is an accredited engineering program that provides students with advanced technical training in data analytics, operations research, software, information systems, and engineering design. And you won't get this kind of focus in a business program. There, you'll likely focus a lot more on things like accounting, finance, human resources, sales, marketing, which we don't actually do in management engineering. And so in management engineering, you are going to be trained as an engineer. You will be eligible for a professional engineering designation. You'll get your iron ring. In business programs, you will earn credits towards finance or accounting certifications. I strongly encourage you to visit our website. When you're clicking on the Future Students button, you'll be redirected to a page with lots of useful information. And what that also includes is links to detailed comparisons of management engineering to a few other programs. Finally, the amazing student experience in management engineering is really what I think sets us apart, and it's marked by a very strong sense of community. The small cohort size creates a tight-knit and collaborative culture in our classes. This is where students find and build close, lifelong personal friendships. Professors and teaching assistants are extremely supportive both inside and outside the classroom. Students are provided with mentorship, extra help, research opportunities. And you'll find management engineering students visible across campus, from design teams to the engineering society, engineering competitions. They have their own intramural teams, many, many student clubs. And students are also involved in extracurricular opportunities that are specific to management engineering. And so we have the Waterloo chapter of the Institute for Industrial and Systems Engineering, and even our own design team, Industry 4.0. We know that the transition to university from high school can be difficult for many students, but at the University of Waterloo, you'll find that first year engineering students have a wealth of resources available to them to ensure their success. There's what are called the WEAF teaching assistants, WEAF TAs, who are free tutors who are dedicated to supporting first year students. And they offer drop-in services, evening sessions, extra help sessions during exams, and so on. I hope you have enjoyed this presentation. We are very proud of our program and our graduates. And I really want to conclude with five takeaway reasons for why management engineering at the University of Waterloo might be the right program for you. This is an interdisciplinary program that gives graduates a unique skill set. And I think it's truly valuable and in really high demand in industry. Through our co-op program, students will earn 2 years of relevant paid work experience. Students at the University of Waterloo are immersed in a rich design and entrepreneurial environment. There are so many opportunities to join student design teams, and there's really an incredible wealth of resources to help launch your idea into the next successful startup. As a student in management engineering, you become part of a family. We take pride in building a very tight-knit community that supports student well-being from day one. And finally, the University of Waterloo is located in a little town in Ontario called Waterloo, but I think it has a very big city feel in addition to being very close to a big city, Toronto. I personally moved to Waterloo from Toronto, and I really find it to be truly the best of both worlds. And through co-op and exchange opportunities, as a student in management engineering, you'll also get opportunities to live and learn really around the world. I really think it's the complete package.